respect your principal sir, teachers and my dear friends. Today I am here in front of you to give a seminar on classification of computers. First of all, let me introduce myself. This is Shivani. I am from Palda. Present, I am pursuing degree BSc Data Science in TSWDC College, Bhopalpally. Our principal sir name is Hari Prasad sir and my in-charge madam name is Archana madam. Comes to my topic, classification of computer. Before knowing about classification of computer, actually I want to say about what is the meaning of computer, who is the inventor of computer and full form of computer. Inventor of computer, I think so you all know that Charles Babbage is the inventor of computer. Full form of computer is commonly operated machine, particularly used for education and research purpose. A computer is an electrical device which stores the process the data and gives the output is known as computer. Comes to my topic, classification of computers. Classification of computers mainly classified into three types: according to purpose, according to data handling and functionality, according to base layer and size. For according to purpose again mainly classified into general purpose computer and specific purpose computer. I think so you all have understood that in name only what is the meaning of general and what is the meaning of specific. Specific means particular, you can identify a particular person, particular thing or particular etc. is known as specific. General purpose computer are designed to perform range of tasks is known as general purpose computer. And in specific are designed to perform only specific programs is comes or specific person. Next, examples of general purpose computers are desktop and laptops are the best examples of general purpose computer. Digital cameras, I think so you are very familiar with digital cameras. Digital cameras comes under specific purpose computer. Next comes to according to data handling and functionality. According to data handling functionality, again mainly classified into three types: analog computers, digital computers and hybrid computers. Analog computers process the continuous data type and digital computers process the discrete data type. Combination of both analog and discrete type data, hybrid computers process both discrete and continuous data type is known as hybrid computers. Mechanical integrators and electronic integrators are the best examples of analog computers. Smartphones, tablets, you know all that you are using nowadays more and more. These are the best examples of digital computers and chemical reaction kinetics are the examples of hybrid computers. I think so you all are clear with this topic. Next comes to based on their size, again mainly classified into five types: personal computers, workstation, multi-computers, mainframe computers and supercomputer. First, personal computers means PC. It is a single-user computers having more than the powerful. I think so you can understand name only what is the meaning of personal. Personal means only one member. One member can use this computer. It is a single-user computer. Next, workstation. It is also a single-user computer similar to PC. However, have more powerful microprocessor. See here, personal computer and workstation computers are both are same, but it has more powerful microprocessors. Next, multi-computer. I think so you can understand in name only what is the meaning of multi. Multi means many. It is a multi-user computer capable of supporting hundreds of users simultaneously. See, I think so you all are understood now what is the difference between personal computer and multi-computer. Personal computer means it's a single user, only one member can use this computer. Next, multi. Hundreds of users can use at a time is known as multi-computer. Next, mainframe computer. It is a multi-user computer system capable of supporting hundreds of users simultaneously. Software technology is different. This multi and mainframe computers both are same, but comes to software technology is different from multi-computer. Next, supercomputer. I think so you all understood in name only what is the meaning of supercomputer. Super means fast. It is an extremely fast computer which can execute hundreds of and millions of instructions per second is known as supercomputer. Next, once again I will explain this. What is classification of computers? Classification of computers again mainly classified into three types: according to purpose, according to data handling and functionality, according to based on the size. According to purpose, again mainly classified into two types: general purpose computer, specific purpose computer. According to data handling and functionality, again mainly classified into three types: analog computers, digital computers and hybrid computers. According to base layer size, again mainly classified into five types: supercomputer, workstation, mainframe computers, multi-computer and supercomputer. I think so you all have understood my topic. Thank you for your patience and attention. Thank you everyone. Thank you ma'am for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you everyone. Stay home, stay safe.